Aki Kareem for British Boxers, and we're down here at Robert Rimmer's Phoenix Camp. And we've got Jack One Smack Massey.
Good to see you as always,
mate. Good to see you, my man. Undefeated in the cruiserweight division. Right. And Jack, we've not caught up since your last fight.
No, no. Leeds, yeah. Great show. You know, tough fight. Tough, awkward fight, but you know, it was good to get the rounds in. Good to get the 8 rounds in. It's good, all good experience in the bank.
Yeah, now you fought Blaize Mendouo. Now, for people who don't know Blaze, you know, he's a real tough dude.
Very tough guy, real tough dude.
And he was fired up for this fight.
Yeah, he was. Come to win,
didn't he?
Yeah, as he's shown at the weigh-in, he did a few little things, you know, come and stood in front, right in front of me, you know. Just, but yeah, he come for the win.
See, he came in really good shape as well.
Yeah, he was in good shape, yeah, because I've watched a few of his other fights and he wasn't, you know, he was a bit flashy, but he was in good shape for this fight.
No, when I saw him on the scales, I thought this could be interesting. And actually, as it turns out, the early rounds were interesting.
Yeah.
He did try and put it on you.
Yeah.
You met fire with fire.
Yeah.
There was a lot of good trading at times as well. So
definitely.
Talk us through the actual early stages of that fight.
Yeah, I mean, early on, like you say, he was coming forward. It was busy. Middle of the fight, just kind of laid off a little bit, and then I think the first three rounds were probably the best three rounds, best rounds. So
it was an interesting one because, you know, I actually think you got asked a few questions in that fight about will, determination, heart.
Yeah.
Because at times, when he was putting it on you, you could have gone into a shell or whatever, but you didn't.
I had to dig deep and just give it back. That's what it's all about, and that's what you enjoy about boxing. You know, you got to enjoy getting in them little holes and digging deep, and you know, so I enjoy it a little bit.
And also, when I actually saw you, sort of, you know, every time I see you, obviously you're dead nice, and everyone says, "Oh, he's such a nice guy." And but you showed in that fight as well that you've got a mean streak.
Yeah, of course, when you got in the ring, it's a different game. It can be a nice guy out of the ring, but once you're in there and someone else is trying to take your head off, you've got a mean business, so.
Yeah. So, you know, as a camp, were you guys happy with the performance?
Yeah, I was happy with everything, yeah. Yeah. You know, it's good to get the 8 rounds in. It's all experience. It's all experience for the later on fights. I mean, it's all right going in there and stopping everyone in the first round, but when you do come to them tough 12 round fights, you're going to come unstuck, aren't you? So
yeah,
it's good to get the experience.
You probably learned a lot more from that than you did from like Russ Henshaw, for example, where you took him out in the first round.
That's it.
Going forward then, what's the plans for next year?
We're looking at fighting in February, maybe the Manchester, I think, February.
Yeah,
not a date yet, but
good. I mean,
look at some titles as well.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're at that stage now where you know, you probably want to be looking for some silver, don't you?
Yeah, definitely. Not sure what we're having first, but we'll look into it, see what's there, and then go from there.
I know a lot of times, you know, we've talked about it before in the past, that the cruiserweight division and all that sort of stuff. So they won't go over all ground, but, you know, it is a division where eventually all of you young, hungry sort of prospects, who are now no longer prospects, you're turning over into sort of more established fighters. Eventually, you're going to meet each other, aren't you?
We're all going to meet each other, yeah. And that's, you know, you can't go around avoiding people. It's not what boxing's about. You need to fight.
Yeah.
And you need to make these good fights and keep the interest there in boxing. And otherwise, people just think, you know, I'm paying loads of money for watching these guys fight bums. I'm not going to turn up anymore. So you need fights like that.
Just thinking ahead, I mean, it could be really exciting. Particularly domestically and obviously in Manchester, you won't have to go too far
for
some decent title shots and some real challenges as well.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a Terry Flanagan undercard, so
it should be
a good night.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, listen, that'd be a great night, wouldn't it?
See what's in the pipeline.
Quality. Well, Jack, it's always good catching up with you.
You too, mate.
You know, and wish you the very best, and looking forward to seeing you in February, and catch up soon, man.
Good night.
Kareem, British boxers, you know the score. Power.